Love, there's so many things I've got to tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know how. 'Cause there's a possibility that you look at me differently, love. Ever since the first moment I spoke your name, from then on I knew that by you being in my life, things were destined to change. 'Cause love, so many people use your name in vain. Love, those who have faith in you sometimes go astray. The joys and hurts, love, for better or worse, I still will choose you first. Oh, 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 oh. Many days I've longed for you, wanting you, hoping for the chance to get to know you, longing for you.
Because sometimes the people who are advising you, they themselves need advising. Man and woman want to tell you how to do, what to do, when they themselves are in a worse predicament than you are in. So the whole idea of marriage means now that you have made a conscious decision that I love mother and I love father and I love friends, but we have got to figure this out together.
Amen.
And we talked about that a little bit when we met at my office. You guys have to figure some things out together. What I like right now is that I remember when the last time you guys were at my office, you were looking stressed. You were looking stressed today. And so that's a good thing. I also want to say to both of you that today is not simply a beginning, but it is really an entrance into your future.
Amen.
This is the opportunity that both of you have to come together and form a future under the auspicious guidance of God Himself.
Amen.
And so I say to you, and I want to encourage you to stay focused. Anytime you make meaningful decisions in life, you're aware of distractions. Things will come up that you did not cater for. Things will happen that you were not prepared for. But here's what the Word of God says. It says, two are better than one. Because when one falls, the other is able to pick that one up. And so what I like in terms of how it ends, it says, but pity to that person who has no one to help them up. Then the Word of God tells us that you ought to love this woman as Christ loved the church. It's a very, very interesting way that the Apostle Paul brings this to life. But I like that it didn't stop there, because it also says that you have to submit to your own husband. And here's where that becomes important, because submission does not mean a situation that is abusive or toxic. But we find ourselves in an environment today where sometimes women find it easier to submit to the boss at the job, to some other male figure, and when you get into the house, it's drama and attitude. And that is not going to find favor with God. And for us, brothers, God expects us to love our wives. I want to conclude by saying this. In marriage, there is no room for a third party.
Amen.
Amen.
No room for a third party. It's you and your wife, and you got to figure some things out. There is no room for a third party. And the third party could be, you know, sometimes the in-laws have to know how to keep their distance. And sometimes you realize that when you get married, you become more attractive. When you get married, you become more attractive. I don't want to go out straight. You guys know what I'm talking about. We live in an environment where people really don't care if you're married. You know? Something about a married man and a married woman is attractive to some people. And what you've got to realize is that you don't need a third wheel. It's interesting that a bicycle only needs two wheels. But if you can't balance the bicycle, then the bicycle does not function well. And you guys are wheels. You guys have to know how to balance things. Amen.
Yes.
So these are just some thoughts that I want to leave with you. And it might not only just be for both of you, but there may be someone in this congregation, in this wonderful audience today, that needed to hear this as they go through either preparing for marriage, in marriage, or thinking about what to do next. At this time, we want to do the exchange of vows. And you'll repeat after me. Good. Take you, Crystal.
Take you, Crystal.
To be my wife. To be my wife. To have and to hold.
To honor.
To cherish.
To cherish.
I pledge my loyalty.
I
will respect you.
I
will love you.
Love you.
There will be no third party. As God has joined us together, no one will separate us.
I, Crystal,
take you, Dennis, to be my husband. To have and to hold, I will honor you as my headship. I will honor you as my headship. Headship. I will cherish you. I pledge to you my loyalty. I will respect you. I will love you. There will be no third party. As God has joined us together, no one will separate. Amen.
Sunshine, I gotta be the one you know. Yeah.